Hi, I'm Nate Webbers, and I'm a software programmer here at the Omax Corporation. About a couple months ago, I had a salesperson who came to me with a unique challenge. He wanted to be able to wow his clients with a very unique part that strictly came off the Omax machine. And so what I'm going to do today is show you how you can take one of these blocks of aluminum, this is a 2-inch by 2-inch aluminum, that's 1-inch thick, and get one of these, an F-22 fighter jet. I cut out my two inch by two inch block ahead of time and need to make sure that we have the block accounted for. And so what I did was I redrew my actual measurements of that block after it was cut into this so that I could determine how the starting traverse is going to line up with the bottom left corner of each of these cuts. So once I have the representation of the block in place, I make sure that my drawing is lined up and proper. And I do know how this is lined up, so I intentionally drew this so that the tail of the front profile and the side profile are lined up. And also I drew this out so that the point where the horizontal stabilizer and the vertical stabilizer should meet with a perfect 90 degrees. So once I have everything accounted for, such as the block and all the alignment, I go ahead and create my three paths. Okay, so now we have the three patterns all mapped out and ready to go. What we need to do now is configure the Omax Make software so that it knows what it needs to do. And so what we're going to do here is go into our Change Path Setup dialog and navigate our way to the folder where this is at. And go ahead and select the first file, which is our front end of the jet. So I also need to make sure that everything is set for what I have on the table. I do have an aluminum piece, but it's not a quarter inch. We're actually going to be cutting through 2 inches of material, so I need to have that set. I'm happy with my tool offset, and I'm also going to enable tilt, courtesy of our Tilt-A-Jet accessory, which will remove taper from the part. So with everything in place, I'm ready to go. I'm going to go ahead and click OK here, but we also need to be sure that we have a perfect point of where our nozzle is in the lower left corner of the material that we're going to be cutting. And now I'm going to go ahead and use a special home that I have, known as F22 Raptor Home in this case, which I created earlier, and I'm going to zero that out. What this does is it gives me a common reference position that I can easily get to if I had to find out where I did this. And it's going to be used as a backup. I'm going to primarily depend on what is known as the path start home. So for a moment, we have our X and Y position set, but we also need to set the Z-axis standoff relative to the material. So now the nozzle's ready to go. We have our proper standoff, and it's at the lower left-hand corner of the material that we're about to cut through. So we're ready to go. And so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go ahead and raise the Z-axis for a moment so I can get our muff on to protect the tilt jet from a backspray while we're cutting. And then I'm going to go ahead and tell the Z-axis to move down to the program height that I had set at. And raise the water level of our tank. And we should be ready to go. From here, click start. Okay, so we just finished up our first cut. So I'm going to go ahead and lower the water level, close out my starting path, and raise up my Z-axis. And we're just going to get the nozzle out of the way. So there's our resulting first cut. I'm going to just clean up my area real quick so I don't have any grit affecting me as I reposition this part. That should do for now. And so what I'm going to do here is I'm going to go ahead and unclamp the clamp that holds this piece in the place to hold my material. And I'm going to carefully reposition this, and the way I'm going to reposition this is I'm going to turn it 90 degrees counterclockwise, and the reason is the top here is going to be the tail of my jet because this is where the jet was best cutting. So I'm just going to go ahead and rotate, and my second profile, the side profile, the tail is going to be back here, so it'll have a real good detail on that tail. So when I'm happy, I'm going to make sure that the material is up against my square apparatus. I'm going to push my holding apparatus back into place, put on a clamp, and make sure that's really tight. You don't want your piece moving as it's cutting, obviously. I need to change this so that we have the second path loaded. If I didn't do that, we would have two of the first path, and that wouldn't be too useful to us. And being that this aluminum is the same thickness as before, we can go ahead and leave it at 2 inches and just about leave everything alone. So I'll click OK to this, and that's it. We're basically ready for cutting. We have the second pattern loaded, so I'm going to go ahead and raise the water level to prevent any splash off and extra noise. Right up there ought to do it. And here we go with the second path. So for the last one, we're actually going to put this on one of its flat surfaces, just like that. So I'm going to still have my tail to the tail here. Move my holding apparatus back into position, make sure everything's nice and square, and then get my clamp back on this. Tighten everything up, make sure it all holds together. Okay, and finally, we want to make sure that we go into MIGS change path setup, pick out the third path, which is the overhead shot. Now this path is the unique one where everything gets broken off as far as the tabs I had in the previous two paths. So the nose will get broken, the wing tips, and the tail section will all be broken off so that this cut will do it all and it'll free the jet from the material. But also, I need to be sure that my thickness is properly set as well. So we'll set that to 1 inch instead. Let me calculate for a moment for the tilt. And we're ready to go here. Raise the water level. And thankfully we don't have to raise it so high this time. And once I'm happy with the water level, we'll go ahead and tell Mate to begin machining. So here's the third cut, starting now. Up 3 inches, I'm going to move the nozzle out of the way. And so here you have to be very careful about how you handle the material. I'm going to go ahead and clean up the general area real quick. And now we're going to go ahead and extract the material from the bed. Be very careful how you pick it up. You don't want to lose anything. So I just released my clamp. And I'm now going to pick this whole block up. I'm going to set it down here. And we're going to see if we can get this to easily extract out. Sometimes you may have to fidget with the material and remove all the blocks, but the jet came out nicely in this case. And so I, like Michelangelo, who knocks away all the bits from the block to get his sculptures, there is your F-22 jet. I'm going to just clean off real quick. Give it a nice wash job. Shake it off. And there you have it. From a block of aluminum, you get one of these F-22 fighters.